Yeah, welcome to magnetic coupled circuits. So today we discuss about the parallel magnetic coupled circuits. Suppose for example I have the two coils. This is coil 1 and this is coil 2. This is coil 2. These two coils are connected in parallel. Let's we assume the dots are placed here. Dots are placed here. So the applied voltage is V. Applied voltage is V and the current supplied by this voltage source is, let it be capital I. Then current flows through the coil 1. This is coil 2. Let the self inductance of the coil 1 is L1, self inductance of the coil 2 is L2, and here we assume that the current through the coil 1 is I1 and current through the coil 2 is I2, and the mutual inductance between the two coils is, let capital M. Yes, now I want to write the equations for both the coils, and before that I want to replace these two coils with the single inductance. So let me assume that these two coils are replaced with the single coil. The inductance of the single coil is, let it be L equivalent. It has to be excited with same voltage and the response of this voltage is same current I. Now here we can write the equation, because these three are connected in parallel, hence voltage across three branches is same. So hence let it be, this is branch 1, branch 2, branch 3. Okay, so then can write V is equal to V1 is equal to V2, where V1 is voltage across coil 1 and V2 is voltage across coil 2. So here we can write the equation for V as, from this network we can write V as L equivalent into di by dt. And what is equation for V1? In the sense V1 is equal to, so first I am writing the equation for this one. What is voltage across inductor? That is L1 di1 by dt. Next. Yes. So this coil has a mutual effect with the second coil, that is the mutual inductance is capital M. And here we can observe that both I1 and I2 are entering at the same end of the two coils. That means you can observe the dots are placed at the same end. So hence mutual effect is positive. As the dots are placed at the same end, hence mutual effect is positive. Plus M into di2 by dt. And we know that this V1 is equal to V. And similarly you can write the equation for L2, that is V2 is equal to, yes, L2 di2 by dt plus mutual effect M di1 by dt. And we know that this will be equal to V, as V1 is equal to V is equal. Now from this equation, let it be equation 1. From equation 1, yes, here we can write, what is equation for di by dt? Di by dt is equal to V by L equivalent. Yeah, let it be, this is equation 2, equation 3. Let it be, this is equation 4. Now if we apply KCL here, you can write the equation as I is equal to I1 plus I2. If you differentiate this equation on both sides with respect to time, then di by dt is equal to di1 by dt plus di2 by dt. Equation 5. Here my interest is I want to find out the values for di1 by dt and di2 by dt by solving these two equations. And if I substitute di by dt here, I will get what is L equivalent. As it is very clear that, so first I want to find di1 by dt and di2 by dt by solving equation 2 and equation 3. And after solving that, by substituting di1 by dt, di2 by dt in equation 5, so we can find the value of di by dt. Once we substitute di by dt in equation 4, we get the value of L equivalent. So let's redo all these things. Okay, first from equation 2 and equation 3, let's write matrix form. So here this V and V is there. So first L1 M, I'm writing matrix form. L2 and this will be di1 by dt, di2 by dt, it is equal to vv. Yes, is it right? Yes, now you can write from equation to v is equal to L1 di1 by dt plus M di2 by dt. Okay. Yes, then di1 by dt. Yes, here our interest is di1 by dt, di2 by dt. Di1 by dt, di2 by dt. That will be equal to L1 M L2 inverse into VV. Yes, we know the inverse of the 2 by 2 matrix. So hence di1 by dt, di2 by dt that is equal to inverse 1 by AD minus BC. A is L1, B is M, C is M, D is L2. So that is inverse 1 by AD minus BC. L1, L2 minus BC, M square, D, L2 minus B minus M minus C minus M, A, that is L1 to VV. Yes, therefore, here directly you can write the equation for di1 by dt. Di1 by dt is equal to, yes, from this di1 by dt is equal to L2 minus V, L2 minus M into V by L1 L2 minus M square. And similarly di2 by dt is equal to L1 minus M into V by L1 L2 minus M square. Okay, now what we need to do, so we want to substitute this, that is di1 by dt, di2 by dt in equation 5. So hence, from, so let it be, this is equation 6. From equation 5 and 6. Equation 5 and 6. So here we can write di by dt is equal to, yes, di1 by dt L2 minus M by L1 L2 minus M square into V di1 by dt plus di2 by dt L1 minus M into V by L1 L2 minus m square, or simply you can write this as L1 plus L2 minus 2m into V by L1 L2 minus m square. Okay, let it be, this is equation 7. Okay, now you substitute equation 7 in equation 4. Equation 7 in equation 4. That is L1 plus L2 minus 2m by L1 L2 minus m square is equal to into V is equal to V by L equivalent. So hence L equivalent is equal to V get cancelled, L1 L2 minus m square by L1 plus L2 minus 2m. Yeah, here as we got 2m minus 2m. So here just you assume when the dots are like this, we got the equation in this fashion. If suppose the dot one is at the top end and another one is at bottom end like this, the dots are like this, then what happened? The mutual effect is negative. Mutual effect is negative. When these two are negative, then this can be rewritten as like this minus. Now this is in this fashion, then this will be plus plus. Here how it will be changed? This is plus m, this is also plus m, here it is plus m plus m plus 2. So hence this is plus 2m. So hence I want to conclude like this. If suppose the two coils are coupled and connected in parallel, dots are like this, L1, L2, mutual inductance is M, applied voltage is V. This can be replaced by single inductance V, L equivalent, where L equivalent is equal to L1, L2 minus M square divided by L1 plus L2 minus 2M. So here you can observe this, whether the net inductance value is increase or decrease. Yes, here's, this is the minus value, so as denominator value is low, hence this will be high value. So when the equivalent inductance is high, so then we used to say the two coils are coupled to aid each other, to aid each other similarly. Two coils are coupled, L1, L2, M, this V. The dots are like this. Dots are placed in this fashion. What is equivalent inductance? That is, equivalent inductance is given by same value. Because you can observe here, the two dots are at top, two dots are at bottom, so there is no change. Suppose the two coils are coupled . One dot is placed here like this. This is L1, L2. Mutual inductance is M. It is V. Yes, then it is L equivalent. So where The value of L equivalent is given by L1 plus L1 L2 minus M square divided by L1 plus L2 plus 2M. Okay. You have the same network, but the dots are placed at different positions. Dots are placed at different position like this. This is L1, L2, let it be M. Now, what is an equivalent inductance? Yes, here the same value, L1, L2 minus M square by L1 plus L2 plus 2M. Okay, now you can see, this is about parallel combination, parallel aiding and parallel opposing. Thank you for watching this.